2013 Paceman, Cooper S, all four.
All four, huh?
Yeah, that's all-wheel drive.
It's gotta weigh a lot.
3,200 pounds. She's a big girl.
Street tires?
Street tires. Yeah, they're essentially like racing slicks on gravel. It's not safe, is the one thing. Doesn't have a roll cage, obviously. Why don't we get buckled up? We'll do that. It's gonna be really fun. Every rally race is made up of a series of stages, and this one was 11 miles long. The idea is to get the fastest time possible for each stage. Then these are added up for your final time. Usually cars leave with a 1 minute gap between them. Normally, that's enough to ensure that no one catches you, but normally you're not in a stock Mini that's about as home here in the woods as an Eskimo eating habanero peppers in the Sahara at midday. You get to actually driving on the stage, and we realize that a street car is not suited for this type of work. Whatever. Let's just go 100 miles an hour through the trees. Sounds like a good idea. 15 seconds. All right. I'm going to go ahead and go into the manual mode of my automatic transmission. Again, highlighting how this is not a good idea. 10 seconds. Okay, here we go. But there's just so much stuff holding it back. The DSC won't let it turn direction. The electric steering is kind of funky. There's so much kind of going for this car, but also so many crutches for daily driving that just keep it from putting in a good stage time.
And the Mini was showing none of its rally heritage. In fact, trying to drive this car on this course this fast was downright dangerous. Stability control broken, the Paceman was finally free from the electronic safety feature.